हेलो नमस्ते, आई एम निखिल खड़कर। अ वार्म वेलकम टू स्मार्ट सॉल्यूशंस, वेयर वी मोल्ड एंड स्ट्रेंथन यूथ फॉर एकेडमिक एंड नेशनल प्रॉस्पेरिटी। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू स्मार्ट सॉल्यूशंस। सो दिस इज आवर सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन सेट्स। टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट a set is. Initially what we did was we discussed the applications of set, then we went through the introduction of set where we discussed some examples that which group can be called as a set, and then the definition of set. So before moving forward in this lecture, let us recapitulate what is the definition of set. So as you can remember, in the previous session we have defined that a set is a group of objects that we can clearly define. What does it mean? It means that, say for example, you have a bunch of keys. Now the bunch of keys can be characterized by what? By simply stating that it is a key, and no more definition or no more explanation is required regarding key. So it is self-explanatory. So this bunch of keys which is clearly defined is called as a set. Also we have considered an example of a box in which there were some balls, say some white balls and black balls, and if you pick out selectively black balls and make a group of it separately, then you can define that group as a group of black balls, and this will now be called as set, because you have now separately taken out black balls, all the black balls in a different group, and now whatever different group you are considering, it has now only black balls. So there are number of objects, that is there are number of balls, and secondary that its property is completely defined, that is it is a ball and its color is black. So this, that a group which can be clearly characterized or which can be clearly defined is called as set. Similarly you can do for white balls. You take out white balls in a separate box, say for example, and then you define that box as a collection of white balls, and this now a collection of white ball is your set. Okay, so now once we know the definition of set, let us look into how to write set. So let us look into how to write a set. Okay, so you know that a group is a collection of objects, and if it satisfies some properties or characteristics, then it is called as a set. So now this group of object, or say a set, I will call it as a set. So a set is represented by capital letters. So what is first thing? First thing is that sets are denoted by capital letters. Okay, so now let us look at the example. How do we do that? See, in the previous example we have considered a box and there were some white balls. So let us say that, let me draw it for your convenience once again. So So let us say this is my set, some set, and it has got collection of white and black balls. Okay, so let me say that this is my set A. So how do I write it? I will represent it by capital symbol, that is capital letter A. You can denote it by any capital letter. So what is A? A is nothing but a group or a collection of balls. And what is the color of balls? They are both white as well as black. So a collection of balls of black and white color. Okay, so this is our set A. Now let us say that what we are doing is we are now taking out some balls from set A and putting it in some other set. Say we take out these 3 balls from set A which are white and we store them separately in another box. So and let me represent this box B by B. Also now we have a third box in which again we take black balls from set A or from box A. Okay, and let me call this box as box C. So now let us write what the set B is. So what we have done is we have taken only white balls in set B. So what is our set B? Set B is collection of white balls, only white balls rather. So what is B? B is my set which I have represented by capital B. And now its description, that is collection of only white balls. Okay, similarly, can you try for set C? Can you define it or can you write it? So try on yourself. Okay, so I will write now. So what is my set C? My set C is collection of only black balls. Okay, so my set C is collection of only black balls. Okay, so now you have understood how to represent a set. So set is always represented by capital letters. Okay, here we have set A, set B and set C. So now let us say that in set B we have 3 balls and let us give them some names. Say their names are B1, B2 and B3. Okay, and in set C we have 2 black balls. So let us give them some names as we have done for white balls. So let us call them as W1 and W2. Okay, so now if you see here, what is B? B is our set. and B1, B2 and B3 are the three white balls, say B1, B2 and B3. So now these balls can be called as elements of set B. Similarly, our set C contains two black balls and we have named it as, say, W1 and W2. Okay, so here also the set C has got two balls, and now we can call these two balls as its two elements. Okay, so each and every set has some elements, rather elements together make a set. So instead of saying that each and every set has got some elements, a collection of objects, as we have initially told, so that objects means elements. Okay, so this collection of elements is a set, and now we have denoted set by capital letters. Okay, and these elements are denoted by small letters. So the second thing in denoting or writing a set is that elements are represented by small letters. Okay, so elements are represented by small letters. Now let us try to write out the elements of set A, B and C. Okay, prior to that we have not yet written definition of elements, so let us write the definition of elements. So elements and its definition. Okay, so what we have understood from here is that elements are the objects in the set. Okay, or the objects in the set are themselves called as elements. Okay, so elements are objects in the set. Okay, so now let us try to write out the elements of set A, B and C. So how do you do that? So initially we have set A, and we know that set is represented by capital letters. Okay, so now we will give is equal to, because we are writing a set of A, and while writing elements we will write in bracket. Okay, so we will write it in curly bracket. So set A contains what all elements it contains? It contains two black balls and three white balls and two. So, and we have given names to this white ball and black ball. So our element, our set A has elements, three white balls. Okay, say B1, B2 and B3. Let me write it here for your convenience. Okay, so they were B1, B2, B3, W1 and W2. What are these? These are the elements. Okay, similarly in B these are the elements, and C these are the elements. So let us write the elements of set A. So in set A we have three white balls, B1, B2 and B3. and each two elements are written by giving a comma in between them. Okay, so we have b1 comma b2 comma b3 and then we have two black balls, so comma w1 comma w2. So now we have written all the elements of set A and now we will complete the curly bracket. Okay, so this is how we write a set and the elements of set. Also you will notice here that b1, b2, b3, w1 and w2 are the elements of A. And so we can say that these elements belong to set A. So there is a special notation for this, that is element belonging to a particular set. So let us look at it, how to represent that. So let us say that b1 and b2, b3, even w1 and w2 belongs to set A. We will only write for say b1. So we have to write that b1 is an element which belongs to set A. So b1 is an element say which belongs to set A, and instead of writing which belongs to, this is the used symbol which states that b1 is an element which belongs to set A. Similarly, now you can write for w1 also. W1 is an element which belongs to set A. Okay. But what if there is an element which does not belong to that set? Say for example Q. So is there an element Q in set A? No. So Q is not an element of set A and we represent it by Q is not an element of set A. Okay. So this is how we write it in mathematical form. So you can just note it down that this symbol, this particular symbol is called as or is read as belongs to. Okay. So now let us try to write the elements of set B and set C. So elements of set B now. So we will write capital B, that is equal to in curly bracket. So what are the elements of set B? It has got only three white balls represented by B1, B2 and B3. So we have set B and its elements are B1, then comma, B2, again comma and B3. Okay. So this is the elements of set B. So now you can see that for set C, I have written here elements. You can also try it on yourself. That is set C, C is represented by capital letter C, then is equal to, then we will begin the elements with curly bracket, write down the elements. So in set C, we had two black balls which were represented by W1 and W2. So we are writing here W1 comma W2 because there are only two elements. And after we have written down all the elements, we will close the curly bracket. Okay. So this is how we write set and the elements of set. Okay. So now you have understood how to define a set or what a set is. And also you know how to write a set and all its elements. So now let us try to solve some problems or rather take some examples where we will be writing some sets. So let us take an example. So this is our example one and say that it states as natural numbers less than 10. Okay. And now we have to write the set. So here you all know that what are natural numbers. So natural numbers are the numbers which begin from 1 and it ends at infinity. Okay, so all these are natural numbers. The statement says that we have to write natural numbers but which are less than 10. Okay, so what are the natural numbers that are less than 10? So they are, say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and will there be 10? No, there won't be 10 because it says that which are less than 10 and 10 is not less than 10. 10 is equal to 10. So we will not take this 10. Okay. So these are the natural numbers which are less than 10. How do we write them in the form of set? So first of all, you will have to represent this set by some capital letter. So let me use here capital N. You can use anything. I am just using capital N. Then we write is equal to, then we begin with curly bracket. And then write all the elements and separate them by giving commas in between them. Okay, so I will just put down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and the last element is 9. So this is my set of natural numbers which are less than 10. Okay, so this is how you write a set in general form. What you can say is that, say N is a set, and in curly brackets what you do is we write all the elements. Okay, you just have to remember this, that in order to write a set you have to represent a set by capital letters, then equal to, and in curly brackets we have to write all its elements. Okay, so now after understanding how to write set, let us move on to next topic. So what is our next topic? Our next topic is methods of writing set. So let us see what are the different methods of writing set. Methods of writing set. Okay, so there are two major methods, or basically there are two methods. First method is called listing method. This is also called as roster method. And the second method that we have is rule method. And it is also called as set builder form. Set builder form. So now we will look into these methods one by one in details. So our first method is listing method or roster method. So I will just put it down. listing method, also called as roster method. So now let us understand the rules of writing set in this method. So what are rules? So first is that in this method what we do is we list down all the elements in that set. So each and every element is written in the curly bracket as we have done earlier. So the first thing is that we list down all the elements, okay. We do not leave any single element. So in this method the sequence of elements doesn't matter. You can write it in any sequence, but you should list down all the elements. And the second most important thing is that you should not write the repeating elements again and again. So for example, if there is some element which is repeating twice or thrice, you should write it down only once and not more than that, okay. So just note down this point that repeating elements should be written only once, okay. Repeating elements should be written only once, okay. So now let us have an example. So the example says numbers divisible by 2 which are less than 10, which are less than 10, okay. So you have to write down this set which says that a set of elements of numbers which are divisible by 2 and at the same time they are less than 10. So can you tell me the elements of this set? What are the elements which are less than 10 and divisible by 2? Okay, so the elements are 2, 4, 6, 8. Again, here we will not include 10 because statement says that the element should be less than 10, okay. So these are the four elements which belongs to this set. So let us write it in this listing method form. So how we write it in the listing method form now? So we will represent this set by say capital A, where my A is a set of numbers divisible by 2 and less than 10, okay. So capital A equals to, and then you have curly bracket and you will write down all the elements. So what are the elements? They are 2, 4, 6 and 8, and then you will close the bracket. So this is how elements or sets are written in listing method. So it is quite very simple how to write it in listing method. So let us take another example. So let us take an example, example number 2. So let us try to write down alphabets of word apple. okay, apple in listing form. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to write down all the alphabets of word apple in listing form. So let us represent this set by say capital B, then that equals to, and now the elements. So what are all the elements of word apple? So they are, so these elements are given in say capital letters, so we will not convert them into small now. We will just write down what are the elements in their actual form. So they are capital A, comma P. So after P we have again P, but our rule says that repeating elements should be written only once. So we will write P only once, and the next element is L. So we will write it L, and after L we have E. Okay, so this is our set. And what is this set? This set is alphabets of word apple. Okay, so now let us take one more example. That is example number 3. Okay, and now this example says that write down a set of whole numbers greater than 10, and you have to write down this set in listing form. Okay, so can you tell me the whole numbers that are greater than 10? So the whole numbers greater than 10, they will start from 11. Okay, and they will be 11 12 13 14, and it will continue, because here we have only one condition which says that which is greater than 10, and there is no limit to it, so it will go to infinity. So now let us try to write down this set in listing form. So let us represent this set initially by say capital D. D is my set of whole numbers which are greater than 10. So I will begin with curly bracket, and the first element we have is 11, then we have 12, then 13, then 14, and these will continue and continue and continue. This will continue, say then comes 1000. Again it continues, 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 continues. You have to continuously write this. Say now you are now reached to 1 lakh, but still the set continues, continues and continues until it reaches infinity. Okay, and then the set will complete. Rather, you cannot go to infinity because you don't know what infinity is. So for such sets, it is sometimes very difficult or not possible to list down all the elements. So how do we tackle with these problems then? If we cannot write down all the elements, how do we tackle? So in order to deal with such problems, mathematicians have come up with a method by which you can tackle such problems. And that method is nothing but our rule method or set builder form. Okay, so now let us look at the second method, that is rule method or set builder form. So we have rule method, also called as set builder form. Okay, rule method or set builder form. So in this method, what we do is, instead of listing down all the elements of that set, we represent all the elements by some variable. And then once we have represented the elements by some variable, we also write its property or characteristics. So let us note down the points that we just said, that we will represent elements by a variable. So elements by a variable. Okay, so you can take any variable, like say x, y, a or b. Variables could be anything. And the second thing is that you have to state the property of that variable. State the properties of that variables. Okay, so what we have to do is, we have to represent all the elements by some variable and then state its properties. So let us take an example so that it will be more clear to you how to write set in set builder form. So let us take an example which says that a set of natural numbers, less than 10. So what we will do initially is, we will identify what are the elements of this set. So the elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So I will just write it for a simplicity. So they are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Now, how do we write them in set builder form? So let us begin it. We will represent, say, this set by say capital P, and then we will put a sign of is equals to. So you know that we always begin writing the elements in curly bracket. Here also we will do it in the same way. So the elements will be written in curly bracket. Now what our first rule say is that we represent elements by a variable. So what are my elements? So these are the elements. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, these are all my elements. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to represent these elements by a variable. So let me represent this by element, say x. I am representing these elements by say a variable x. So x is my variable. So when I represent some elements by x, what does it mean? What is the value of x? So x will take all the values. Say x will be equal to 1, x will also be equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 and 9. So x will be equal to all the values from 1 to 9. That is, x will be equal to all the elements. Okay, so first we will represent element by a variable that we have done. So let us write here x, which represent my all the elements. Okay, followed by a vertical bar. Vertical bar is represented to indicate such that. Okay, so this is my variable and vertical bar will be read as such that. Okay, so the elements of my set are such that, or the variable x is such that, and what is x? X is a variable which firstly belongs to natural numbers. Okay, so what is our first condition? First condition is that x belongs to natural numbers. So we will write that x belongs to natural numbers. Okay, also there is some other condition that it is natural number but it is less than 10. Okay, so this is also very important. So we will write it x is also less than 10. So now you can see here that initially what we have done, we have written all the elements in the form of variable and then we are writing its property. So first property was that x belongs to natural numbers, and the second property is that it is less than 10, okay, which we have written here. So this is how we completely write the set in set builder form. So what is this and what is this? So this is nothing but property. Say this is property 1, and this is property 2. This can also be called as condition. Okay, so this is very important for us, that how to write a set in set builder form. So now let us take some examples so that we will have more practice of it. So let us take an example. So the example says, write a set of prime numbers between 10 and 10,000. In set builder form. Okay, so what we have to do here is we have to write a set of prime numbers and that too between 10 and 10,000 in set builder form. So what we will do, first of all we will represent this set by say capital letter, say Q. Okay, so Q is my set of prime numbers between 10 and 1,000. So how do we do that now? First of all, let us say that we consider here a variable x which is nothing but all the elements, that is all the prime numbers between 10 and 10,000. Okay, so x is my variable such that x belongs to, what does x belong? X belongs to prime numbers. X belongs to prime numbers. Also, what information does x have? That it is between 10 and 10,000. Okay, so my x is between 10 and 10,000. So x is greater than 10. And also x is less than 10,000. Okay, so this is how we have written set Q, that x is my variable which is a prime number and which is between 10 and 10,000. Okay, so that's it for the day. In the next session, we will look at the type of sets, that is, what are the different types of set. Thank you. Admissions are currently open for academic year 2020-21. For all further information and for your queries, you can contact us on the number shown on your screen. And finally, I would say that to complete your education with flying colors, join Smart Solutions today. Thank you.